everybody. Guess who? It's Pastor Dee Dee after a long time bringing back the Shofar Blast. So much is happening in the world. So much is happening in our nation. So much is happening in our state of Colorado, and I'm sure in your state, your country. And we're going to have a new platform in a sense. We're going to have a recorded session, which is what this is right now. So there's no interaction and live chat that can happen. But we're going to be bringing news to you, breaking news that's happening in the world that not necessarily the church is listening to or has time to delve into, but this will be quick snippets of what is happening. And then in our live chat time, when we do Facebook Live, we're going to have interaction, because in between, you're going to have an assignment. And that assignment is to strategically ask the Lord to give you strategy on how to dismantle and how to pray into the news of the day and what I bring to you, so that we can see effectual praying of a saint, of a warrior in the body of Christ, so we can see this stuff pulled down in our nation. So we're going to get right to it. I'm so excited for you all to join us and to be a part of this, because you are vital to see the enemy brought down in this nation, especially in this nation right now. We are coming upon Purim. And Purim is that amazing time, remember, in the Bible when Esther came and had the ear of the king. And in that, Mordecai was saved, and the Haman noose that was set to hang Mordecai turned and Haman was hung. And so every year there's a celebration, and it's one of the Jewish festivals that is celebrated called Purim. And it is coming up on March 9th into March 10th. Every year something wild happens. Last year, you know what happened? Last year, do you all remember the infamous Mueller report that was supposed to take down our president? Well, guess what it did? The Mueller report came out. The next day it was Purim, and the whole thing blew up in the face of the enemy. It came out, it was a nothing burger. And so I'm excited to see what's going to happen this year. A lot is going on, so I want to get to it. I shared this past Sunday in our fellowship, Gateway on Mount Zion. We would love to have you all come. We know there's a lot of people out of the nation. If you ever come to Colorado, we would love for you to come so we can put our arms around you. We have a ball. We just have fun. We never know what's going to happen. Well, this Sunday, the Lord had put on my heart to really address the coronavirus, because the enemy has taken this and has blown it up into such a place of fear and panic globally. All of a sudden, it shows up. Did you notice how all of a sudden it just showed up and blew up overnight? Well, the mainstream media has a lot to do with that. And we need to, as warriors, watch our mouths, that we're not spreading that fear and we're not spreading that panic and terror. We're called to bring peace. We are called to bring truth. And truth always brings peace. And so I'm going to give you some statistics. I'm going to talk a little bit about this virus so that there is perspective, because truth brings peace. And where are you giving your ear and where are you giving your eye? We're going to talk about that in a little bit as well, because that's important this year. 2020. 2020 means a lot, and so does 5780, which is the year that we are in Hebraically. The two came together and converged. That's exciting. In the next several Shofar Blasts, we'll be talking about that and what the word is for this year. And we're going to share about that. But let me get into some of these statistics. Worldwide, right now, the update is 89,000 people worldwide are infected with the coronavirus. 100 of those are in the United States. Yes, I said 100 in the United States. It has spread to 12 states, and there have been 6 deaths. And those deaths have come from a nursing home facility. And those that are targeted in this, that it affects the most, are the elderly, and not even just the elderly, but those who are compromised physically, who have an underlying chronic disease of, and it's weakened their bodies. And so I just want to let you know, 100 people in the U.S. have it in the U.S., okay, have the virus. Okay, now listen to this. The flu, you know, F-L-U. We all know about influenza and the flu. We've been dealing with this for years. The flu, the CDC states that there's between 12,000 and 66,000 deaths per year. Now, we've had six in a matter of a couple months, but we are talking 12,000 to 66,000 deaths with the flu. In 2017 to 2018, that season, it was a horrific season. 80,000 people died from the flu. Now, what this whole thing has done for me, this is what the enemy means to bring panic and heartache and hurt and death. What happens is truth comes up in many different ways. So what I found out for the first time, I didn't know. Did you know there were 80,000 deaths in 2017 to 2018 in that season? I had no idea. I was clueless. Did you know that there's between 12,000 and 66,000 deaths a year? No. So guess what we're going to be praying about? We're going to pray about corona, but you know what? This is even worse. Look what the flu is doing. And we as believers need to stop this. We need to come against that in Jesus' name. We need to send truth revealed into that and resurrection life into that. So far this season, 32 to 45 million people will get the flu. Now, we're not going to get the flu. I'm not going to confess that. I don't want the flu. I'm not going to get the flu. You're not going to get the flu. But those are the statistics from the CDC. Right now, they're suggesting and projecting 310,000 people have already had the flu. 310,000. Right now, there's 100 people in the U.S. that have corona. Okay? 560,000 people are going to be hospitalized or have been this season with the flu. 14,000 people so far in the U.S. have died. 14,000 people have died this season because of the flu. All right. Do you see the mainstream media going wacko over that? Have you ever asked yourself a question? Why? What's going on here? What's the underlying strategy of the enemy to cause panic, to cause mayhem? It may have started out politically. Could have. Let's crash the systems. Let's crash the let's crash all of the stock market. Let's do that. That may have been the underlying plan of the enemy. But let me tell you what his biggest plan is. It's to shut you and I up. It's to isolate us. It's to get us wearing face masks everywhere. And don't you touch me. It's to cause division and a separation in the body of Christ, which is the greatest weapon against this stuff, is the one voice and the shout of the declaration of the people of God. That's what the enemy is trying to shut up. And so I encourage you to go to the CDC. Go online, research. Don't just listen to the news people. There's motivation behind all the things that they, most of the things that they shoot from their mouths. There's a motivation and it is not godly. So I encourage you to research. Let me tell you really quickly what part of the word that the Lord gave me for this year. First of all, this is the year 5780. We entered that Hebraic New Year, which I love it. It's the Jewish New Year. And you guess what? As a believer, we have Jewish roots. We need to know what our Jewish roots are to understand the signs and to understand the times that we live in. It's an amazing thing. 57:8 is the year of the mouth. Can you believe this? It's the year of the mouth. And when I delivered this word, it was the 27th of December. You can go back in the archives on our website. It's gomz.org. And you can go to the archive on the 27th of December and hear the whole word. But the Lord had shown me Hebraically, that it's the year of the mouth. It's the word pay, P-E-Y. So our exhortation to our body and to you, watch your mouth. Watch your mouth. And I love it because 2020 converges with that. And 2020, what do you think that means? Well, I think it has something to do with sight. Not only eyesight, but most importantly, insight. And our ear gate. So what comes in our ears? Blah, 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 blah. Oh my gosh, we're going to die. We're going to die. We all have to get masks. We all. And by the way, CDC and the Surgeon General says, please don't get a mask because you are buying them all up and people who really need them, which is the medical community, can't get them. We don't need a mask because first of all, you have to be sick. That's the only time that it's good so you don't make other people sick. So let's take a breath. Take a deep breath, body of Christ and warriors, and let's just come into calmness and peace because peace is a fruit of the Spirit. And you can hear God when you're in shalom. It's hard to hear God when you're freaked out and panicked. But when you're in shalom, you know, shalom, peace, is the potting soil for revelation. Isn't that awesome? Peace is the potting soil for revelation. So allow peace to take you over instead of panic taking you over, okay? Because this is going to be important for you to get strategy as we do these shofar blasts. I want you to tell me what the Holy Spirit is giving you strategically to dismantle fear in this nation. It was so awesome because Generals International, which is Cindy Jacobs' ministry, had a global call this morning. And she was rallying all the troops to pray against what I'm talking about. The spirit of fear and panic over this coronavirus. Not the flu that's, you know, 80,000 deaths in 2017. No. But the corona. Ask yourself why. Go to Jesus. Say, okay, what's going on here? Strip away. I just strip away all of the facade and all the hiding and all the camouflaging spirit. Lord Jesus, what's going on? And let him show you what's going on. All right, so we have 2020, which represents expectancy. It represents waiting. And listen to this, accountability and responsibility. Do you know we have responsibility to shut our mouths? We have responsibility for this right here. These two little lips right here, they cause us the biggest problem. And they spew things in the atmosphere for good or bad. Remember death and life? Remember that scripture? Death and life are in the power of the tongue. So we have accountability this year. And we need to be expecting. What are you expecting? Are you expecting disaster and everything's going to fall apart? And, oh my gosh, I can't say anything to anybody because I'm going to get what they've got. You know what? Again, take a breath. Are we expecting the greatest awakening and revival that this planet has ever experienced? That's the bottom line. That's what the enemy is trying to stop. Politically, yeah, there's things happening. But you know what? The enemy wants to stop the bride of Christ. He wants to stop the one voice gathering together and declaration out of the mouth in the year of the mouth. He wants to shut us all up and shut us down. And lock us up somewhere to where we can't even see each other because we're scared. You know what? You need to rip that off and understand that we are a powerhouse and we are a formidable power in this time. Our agreement and our declaration against that spirit in Jesus' name. Here's part of the word. The birthing waters have broken and rivers of new life are released. New, life, flowing within this house, your temple, filling it up and overflowing to outpour where? To the nations. Well, it's really hard to go on mission trips when you have border closings. Isn't it hard to go to the missions and when they shut the borders down? That's the plan. Is to shut every border around the world down because we're afraid because two people have got the virus in a city or a state. You know, it's demonic. It's to shut us down. There was a woman watching on Sunday whose daughter was in a nation. She's a missionary over there. Simultaneously, when she was watching on, like you're doing right now, her daughter called from the mission field. And as I was saying, the plot of the enemy is to stop missions and to keep everyone with isolated. She said, Mom, the plan of the enemy is to shut down missions. That is the bottom line. It's the bottom line. So we need to go to that bottom line and blow it up. In this year of expectancy, expect the birth. Expect good. Expect joy. Expect hope. Expect love. Expect peace. Expect light. Expect life. Expect Him. Well, no. There's a coronavirus. It's going to get me. It's going to get me. What you prepare for is what you get. So what do you want? Him or it? It's your choice. Prepare to receive the goodness of God. All right, search for me with your whole heart and you will find me in every situation and circumstance that comes your way. Give no place or toleration to the enemy of fear. Never allow the enemy to dictate your future, but remind him of his. You got to remind him of his instead of him always saying, you're going to die, you're going to get this, you're going to crash, your finances are going to go, you're going to die, you're going to this. If you look at your future through the eyes of offense, pain, hurt, or fear, it's through brokenness. Your vision's blurred and impaired, unable to discern deception or the distortion of truth. When you hear what people are saying, even in the news, are you hearing through the eyes of insight, 2020 spiritual insight, or through fear and brokenness? Oh my gosh, oh my gosh. View everything through my eyes, the Lord says. See all people, things, and circumstances as I see them. I pray that the light of God will illuminate the eyes of your imagination. I'm declaring this over you. I am declaring this over every one of you because I need you. I need every one of you to be sharp as a tack in your insight because we have some business to do. This Shofar Blast is going to do some business, and we're going to do major business in the kingdom of the enemy and for the kingdom of God. So I declare that the eyes of your imagination are going to be enlightened, flooding you with the light of God until you experience the full revelation of the hope of His calling for your life. That is the wealth of God's glorious, listen to this, of God's glorious inheritances that He finds in us, His holy ones. That's Ephesians 1:18. So we're going to have fun. And I encourage you to become a follower. Jump on board. We need every single one of you joining in when we do it live. And I'll be doing that live. We may be in different locations or whatever. And I'm going to pop it up and say, okay, here we go. I need you to be on alert right now because this is what's going down and we need to strategically dismantle this in the spirit. So this is going to be an active, you're not going to just listen to me, watch me. Oh, look at, you know, her lipstick's on wrong. Yeah, probably. Her hair's out of place, that's for sure. So, you know, it's not about that. We are going after that which is trying to stop harvest. And we're going to watch God with the host come in and make toast of the enemy, just like Kat Kerr says. We're so excited. So by the way, before I close, we want to invite you to tune in or come. This Sunday, we have a South African prophet, Benjamin Arday. I tell you, he is a boom, boom prophet. You know, he just says it like God gives it to him. He doesn't placate flesh. Isn't that refreshing? So that's an amazing thing. 10:30, we invite you to come. We have this amazing new Gateway Cafe that's going to be opening. And we're going to have a Benji coffee drink. I'm not a real coffee drinker, but everybody is raving over this coffee. So we're excited. We just want to bless you this Sunday. The following Sunday, we have an apostle coming. He's a revivalist, and that's Bill Easter. Wow. The last time he was here, we all were on the floor crawling because of the power of God. So we invite you to that. And I'll be announcing other speakers that are coming. I'll just give you a quick, well, Lana Vassar is coming. and that's going to be in April. So we have people coming, and we're excited, and we invite you to be a part. So Father, in the name of Jesus, right now, we declare your word that, Father God, you who've begun a good work in every person that is watching, you're going to complete it. And Lord, I strip off and loose all fear. And we are all joining together in this. Every person, we strip off and loose a spirit of fear, deception, exaggeration over our lives, over our families' lives, over our churches, in Jesus' name. And Lord, we bind our souls to the truth of who we are in you, Christ Jesus. We bind our souls, Lord God, to the word of truth, to peace and shalom, to the fruit of the Spirit. And we send the hosts to absolutely destroy this demonic attack, this virus, this demonic assignment and strategy. We send the host to strip it of power in Jesus' name. Amen. By the way, P.S. The numbers in China that have this virus, where it started, have just suddenly started going down. Do you think the prayer is working? I think so. God bless you. I love you. We'll see you next time.